Anatomy of the anterior abdominal wall. First of all, what are the layers of the anterior abdominal wall? The layers of the anterior abdominal wall are 9 layers. 3 superficial, 3 deep, and in between there are 3 muscles. First of all, the 3 superficial layer. Sure, when you come in contact with the anterior abdominal wall, the first layer you palpate is the skin. The skin of the anterior abdominal wall is thin skin. And the most important feature in this skin is the umbilicus. The umbilicus is a scar, inverted scar, inside the anterior abdominal wall, in the middle line. Sure, we all know that this scar formed due to separation of the umbilical cord stump after birth. The umbilicus present at variable level, but usually and anatomically it is about 1 finger below the midpoint between the xiphoid process and the symphysis pubis. We all know this bone is a xiphoid process, and this bone in the pelvis is the meeting of the 2 hip bone in the midline anteriorly, which is called symphysis pubis. And the umbilicus normally midway between the xiphoid process and symphysis pubis, or within 1 finger below this point. Or actually it is said that the umbilicus lies at the level between the disc, between L3 and the L4 vertebra. The umbilicus is an important level in the anterior abdominal wall. Why the umbilicus is important level in the anterior abdominal wall? Because the anterior abdominal wall above the umbilicus, the venous drainage and the lymphatic drainage above the umbilicus ascend upward to drain into the axilla. While the anterior abdominal wall below the umbilicus, the venous drainage and the lymphatic drainage drain downward into the groin. The level of the umbilicus is an important level of anastomosis between superior vena cava, which drain the anterior abdominal wall above the umbilicus, and tributaries of inferior vena cava, which drain the anterior abdominal wall below the umbilicus. Also, the umbilicus is an important site for anastomosis between portosystemic anastomosis. Anastomosis between the portal circulation, which drains the GIT, and the systemic circulation, which draining the remaining part of the body, other than the GIT. The umbilicus normally is inverted. Why? Because posterior to the umbilicus, there are fibrous ligaments and 1 peritoneal ligament attached to the posterior surface of the umbilicus. What is this view? If this is the anterior abdominal wall, this is the skin, and this is the deep surface of the anterior abdominal wall. Come here and sit down inside my abdomen and look to the anterior abdominal wall. Scientifically, this is the posterior surface of the anterior abdominal wall. This is a posterior view to the anterior abdominal wall, and this is the umbilicus. The umbilicus is attached to median umbilical ligament, which is attached between the umbilicus and the apex of the urinary bladder. And lateral to the median umbilical ligament, there are two medial umbilical ligaments. Medial umbilical ligaments. The medial umbilical ligaments representing the obliterated distal part of the umbilical artery. And from above, this ligament is called ligamentum teres, or round ligament of the liver, which lies in the free border of this peritoneal fold, which is called the falciform ligaments. Due to presence of all these fibrous ligaments on the inner aspect or the posterior aspect of the umbilicus is pulled backward and it is inverted. What is the nerve supply of the skin of the umbilicus? The skin of the anterior abdominal wall. The skin of the anterior abdominal wall is supplied by intercostal nerves from intercostal nerve 7 to 12. Intercostal nerves from 7 to 12 plus L1 nerve. The skin of the umbilicus is supplied by T10, which is the same nerve supply to the appendix. And this is very, very important. Why? Because in appendicitis, which is a very, very common disease, the pain start generalize the abdominal pain, especially around the umbilicus, because the skin of the umbilicus and the appendix are both supplied by T10 segment of the spinal cord. This is the first layer, which is called the skin. The second layer of the anterior abdominal wall is superficial fascia. This I cut section, we cut the skin. And deep to the skin, there is superficial fascia. The superficial fascia, especially below the umbilicus, differentiate into two layers. Superficial fatty layer. The superficial fatty layer is called Cambers fascia, which is one of the major sites of storage of fat all over the body. Deep to the Cambers fascia, which is actually subcutaneous fat, the superficial fascia show a membranous layer called deep membranous layer. Therefore, the superficial fascia is formed of superficial fatty layer and the deep membranous layer. The deep membranous layer is called the scarbus fascia. The scarbus fascia is well developed below the umbilicus and below. It is attached where this scarbus fascia and below. On both sides, it is attached to the fascia lata. We all know that fascia lata is the deep fascia of the thigh. The scarbus fascia is attached to the fascia lata, which is the deep fascia of the thigh, about one finger below this famous ligament. What is the famous ligament which is present here? One finger below the inguinal ligament. In the middle, scarbus fascia continue to surround the penis. and surround the scrotum. And in this case, when it descends to surround the penis and scrotum, it becomes called nowadays, coolest fascia. Therefore, coolest fascia is the fascia of the scrotum, which is continuation of scarabeus fascia. Coolest fascia end posteriorly by fusion with the posterior border of perineal membrane. Posterior border of perineal membrane. This green line is the scarabeus fascia, descends around the penis and the scrotum, and the scarabeus fascia fused with the perineal membrane. Thus, here formed a pouch called superficial perineal pouch. The superficial perineal pouch containing many structures. The most important structure is the urethra. Here, the part of the urethra in the bulb of penis, which is called the bulbar urethra. There is here a very important applied anatomy should be remembered always. If you receive trauma in the perineum, here, in the superficial perineal pouch, this may lead to rupture of bulbar urethra. If there is rupture of bulbar urethra, when the patient try to micturate, the urine extravasate means comes out from the normal passage. The urine does not pass in the normal passage to outside through the penis. The urine extravasate here in the superficial perineal pouch. Then by continuous micturation, the urine fill here, collect in the scrotum, then collect in penis. By continuous attempt to micturate, the urine accumulate here. The urine accumulate here between the muscles of the anterior abdominal wall and the scarabeus fascia. This is very, very important in rupture urethra. The first thing should be said to the patient, never attempt to micturate, because any attempt to micturate leading to extravasation of urine in the superficial perineal pouch, then forward in the scrotum, then forward in the penis, then forward in the anterior abdominal wall between the muscles and the scarabeus fascia. These are the three superficial layer of the anterior abdominal wall: skin and superficial fascia. And superficial fascia is formed of superficial fatty layers called Cambers fascia and deep membranous layer called scarabeus fascia. These are the three superficial layers. In the next video, we'll take the muscle layer. Thank you for good listening and good luck.